All right, hello, this is Darren, and I have another fishing rod review for you. Today I'm going to do another video. I did one earlier in the year. This is about a collapsible style fishing rods, something you can take on a trip with you without having to worry about finding a way to put it in the car or, you know, strap it on the airplane somehow. Put in your backpack. This thing is a good survival rod. Not this one. Well, this one could be. And this one. So there's three different models. All these can be found on eBay. I haven't found them in stores anywhere yet. So let's start with this one here. This one was $11.95 shipped. It's supposed to be a spinning rod. It measures 26 inches when it's collapsed, and when it's in this fully extended, it's about 6 foot. Not very impressed with this. The quality is just horrible. As far as the real seats, they feel real cheap plastic. I mean, they're hard to open, hard to close. The cork feels pretty good, and the butt has a storage area that's fairly good, and it's fairly large diameter. You could put, you know, a fairly nice sized rooster tail in the bottom of that. But it doesn't go very small, and it's just looks kind of cheap. And the line guides are small. They're not really good for spinning reels. Most of these that I want are for spinning reels, and it says it's for spinning, but the line guides I think are too small for that. So that's out. The next one that came in at let's see, $12.15 shipped, and it is looks like something that you would use in Jamaica. It's got a nice little weird handle that looks like doesn't even belong on a fishing rod, but it's got green and red and blue and orange stripes on the butt of it, and it measures about 18 inches, and they all come with protectors for the end. This one here extends out to I think about the same, about 6 foot. Yep, 6 foot, and supposed to be made of carbon fiber. Looks like it's well made, but the eyelets for the line guides are way too small for a spinning reel, and it does have a unique kind of weird reel seat. It works. It's not very comfortable, but it does get the job done. As far as a survivalist one, this is definitely your smallest option that I found that's, you know, unique looking and well made. Has storage in the butt, but not very big. So that one's out for me. Then comes the one that I'm most excited about. This one here, I liked it so well, I bought 6 more. And I'm actually gonna take 2 of them out and break them for you right here in just a little bit and show you what they'll take as far as abuse. But as far as the workmanship goes on this, this is first class. This is really a good deal. It's actually a little bit more money. It's about $20 shipped to you from in the United States. It goes down to 23 inches, which is an accessible size, but it's what I like about it is so comfortable in the hand. It has a nice foam grip. You would think you'd had a one-piece rod in your hand when you're using this thing. It's super lightweight and a very, very nice build quality. It comes with this really large plastic, hard plastic clear end protector, and it has large eyelets that's actually looks like it's made for spinning rod. And then when I first opened up, I thought, oh man, it broke already, but it's not. Don't be alarmed. The last section goes out super thin, and it has an eyelet that you push right down here on the middle, and that way you have an eyelet here in the middle to take off some stress on the last section. So it's actually, the way it works is so much better design than all the rest of these. So very impressed. Let's take them out right now, and I'm going to show you what it takes to break one of these.
Okay, yeah, I already pulled the drags. So far, so good. Let's crank the drag all the way up. God, this is almost lifting the anchor. Oh, there we go. It broke in the middle, but it splintered. So that's what happens when you try to lift a boat anchor with a Chinese collapsible fishing rod. It did not break where I expected. I thought it would break out on the tip.
Keep from hurting myself. Got a helmet with a shield on it. I'm going to put that over my face. I don't know what's going to happen here. I kind of do, so that's why I'm putting it on. All right, so this is just normal fishing with it. You got, you know, the drag is going to going to keep from breaking the rod. So you tighten the drag a little bit, get that fish in. Seems to be doing good if just normal everyday action with it, right? So what's going to take to break this thing? It's going to take an awful lot of stupidity to put that much force on it to start with. So let's crank this drag up all the way and see what it'll take. I can start to feel cracking here. Whoops, it broke the string. Huh. We may have to go get her stronger. Okay, try this again. That broke the string. That's a 20 pound braid, sorry. So, okay, got her. Just let it off a little so we got more string. So they say these about right in there. So let's tighten it down. I'll try to lift this anchor. I'm gonna have to tighten it down a little more. So this rod's holding up pretty well for just if you don't abuse it. Ah, oh, God, I'm lifting the anchor. This one's holding up better than the last one. I've got that anchor. Oh, there we go. Finally broke, but that anchor was starting to come off the ground. That's pretty impressive for just a cheap $20 rod. I'll take all these I can get. Put one in every car. It broke it, and then how you tell good break if it splinters. If it just snaps off even, like it did up there, I think that might have snapped on whiplash. But that's a sign of a good rod if it splinters like that. All right, so as you can see, we broke a couple of them there. This one just, which was the last one, it only just broke in two places, once here, and then maybe the whiplash broke it off there, but it did splinter fairly good, so it looks like it's very well made. The tip didn't break on this one. Now on the first one, the tip snapped off. I don't know what it was, whether it's just the whiplash or what, and also knocked out an eyelet out of the larger side. So the eyelets can come out. You know, if you're worried about it, you might add a little extra glue before that happens. But you know, all of them seem to be very, very well made, as good as the Fuji eyelets, and the real seat definitely is good or better than a Fuji. It actually looks like it might be a Fuji. But very, very impressed with the toughness and quality of this one. I used this is a damn quick 330 series Finessa with 20 pound braid. I did snap the line once, but I think it could have been a bad spot on the line, or may have grazed it with the knife, who knows. Then the first rod I broke, I used a damn quick super, that one of my modified wheels, because I think it had 50 pound braid on it, so I wanted something that would hold up and break these things without any problem. So we found out what it takes to break one. These rods are definitely keepers, even though, you know, like I say, you could break anything. The tip, what it takes to break the tip is going to be more than just bending it like that. It's going to be, you're going to break it with, you hit something in the ground, or you roll it up in a window, or snap it like that right there. I just broke the tip just by a shear type force. A shear force will break it. So you got to be careful with the tip. Use common sense when you're reeling in big fish with this thing. Use your drag, not the rod. And you should have a pretty pleasant fishing experience. Anyway, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I have more fishing reel reviews and fishing equipment reviews, we'll say. And thanks for watching.